वेलकम बैक टू इकोनॉमिक्स लर्निंग। टुडे वी डिस्कस इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज। इंडिकेटर्स ऑफ ह्यूमन रिसोर्सेज रिफर टू मेजर आर मैट्रिक्स यूज टू असेस वेरियस एस्पेक्ट्स ऑफ वर्कफोर्स विद इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन। दीज इंडिकेटर्स प्रोवाइड इनसाइट्स इनटू द क्वालिटी, क्वांटिटी, एफिशिएंसी एंड इफेक्टिवनेस ऑफ ह्यूमन कैपिटल मैनेजमेंट। Here are some key indicators of human resources. First one is employee turnover rate. This measures the percentage of employees who leave the organization over a certain period. High turnover rates may indicate issues with recruitment, retention, or workplace culture. Second one is employee satisfaction and engagement. Surveys or assessments are used to gauge employees' satisfaction with their jobs, workplace environment, and organizational culture. High levels of satisfaction and engagement are often associated with increased productivity and employee retention. Third one is retraining and development investment. Tracking the amount of resources allocated to employee training and development program can indicate the organization's commitment to improving skill knowledge and capabilities within the workforce. Fourth one is absenteeism rates. Absenteeism rates measures to a frequency and duration of employee absences from work. High absenteeism rate may signal underlying problems such as poor health, job dissatisfaction or work-related stress. Next one is employee performance review. Evaluating individual and team performance against set objectives provides insight into the productivity and effectiveness of employees. Performance reviews can be help identify top performer areas or for improvement and training needs. Next one is skills and competencies inventory. Maintaining a record of employees' skills, competencies, certification, and qualifications help in workforce planning, talent management, and succession planning. Next one is diversity and inclusion metrics. Tracking diversity metrics such as gender, ethnicity, age, and disability status can help assess the organization's effort to in fostering a diverse and inclusive workplace. 8th point is employee benefits utilization. Monitoring the usage of employee benefits such as healthcare, retirement plan, and wellness program provides insights into employee satisfaction and well-being. Next one is workforce demographics. Analyzing the composition of the workforce by age, gender, education level, and job role helps in understanding workforce dynamics and planning future recruitment and training strategies. Next one is employee productivity and efficiency. Metrics such as revenues per employee, output per hour, and sales per employee measures the efficiency and productivity of the workforce. Next one is workforce flexibility. Assessing the organization's ability to adapt to changes in demand or market conditions through metrics like part-time employment, temporary staffing, or remote work arrangements. Last one is succession planning and talent pipeline. Evaluating the readiness and availability of employees to fill key positions within the organization help in identifying potential gaps and developing talent pipeline. These indicators provide valuable insights into the performance capabilities and well-being of an organization's workforce, enabling HR professional and organizational leaders to make informed decisions and develop strategies to optimize human capital management. Thanks for watching.